Now, when we look at reviews over the year, it is clear that we are mainly reviewing Hyperwings models. That's just because they make a lot of Scale 500 models where other manufacturers don't. But it is nice once in a while to take a look at what other manufacturers do. And with that, hello and welcome to a new episode of Review, the last episode in 2021. And today we take a look at a Boeing 747-400 of Virgin Atlantic. At the front of the box we have a cutout so we can get a glimpse of the aircraft model inside, and underneath that we have the Virgin Atlantic branding. The backside of the box, well, typical for Sky 500, it doesn't offer much. Let's say it like this, still it is way better than anything Harper currently has to offer. And here she is, the lovely, the beautiful, the queen of the skies, the Boeing 747-400 in the last standard livery of Virgin Atlantic applied to this aircraft type. Virgin Atlantic did indeed at some point have 13 of these 747-400s in their fleet, which however all were retired by beginning of 2020 due to the corona pandemic. The aircraft model itself from Sky 500 was produced in 2013. Now with that out of the way, let's take a closer look at the aircraft model itself to see what it actually has to offer. And as always, we start our tour around the aircraft model with a look at the tail section, where we on the vertical stabilizer find the Virgin branding. On top of the stabilizer, we then have the last two letters of the registration code. The full registration code we then find on the fuselage, and towards the very tail of the aircraft, we do also have a bit of detailing around the APU exhaust. At the front of the aircraft and across the fuselage, we then have the writing of Virgin Atlantic, and underneath that we have the aircraft type specification. Also very typical for Virgin Atlantic is of course the addition of this pin-up girl, also known as the Scarlet Lady, which carries the Union Jack, and underneath that we have the name of the aircraft. The cockpit section itself could definitely have benefited from a few more details in the print, but what we do have is the cockpit windows with the window wipers, and above the cockpit windows the emergency hatch for the cockpit. The engine nacelles have been given the typical Virgin Atlantic red. I would almost call it like a cherry red. I do very much like this color, but we don't really have any printed details other than the silver leading edge, which is a little bit disappointing. The physical detailing, however, is excellent on these engines, especially here from the front. Very, very nice. You can see the engine fan blades. From the engine, we can move on to the wings, which we should also take a closer look at. Starting off with the top side, where we can see the different flap slats and spoilers have been carved out, although that could definitely have been much more pronounced, but we do have some different shades of gray for additional detailing. We do have some lovely physical detailing, however, on the underside of the wings, where we also find the full registration code of the aircraft has been printed on once more. And then, of course, with the 747, we also have the winglets again with this lovely cherry red color, and on the other side, also the Virgin branding. And then we have the landing gear, which is mostly made out of metal and also has a feature of rolling wheels. I'm not a huge fan of that, but I know some people very much like it. The front landing gear also the same thing, metal and rolling wheels, but no printed details here, which is a bit disappointing. That, however, we find on the belly of the aircraft, where we can see the writing of Virgin Atlantic has been added. And then last but not least, we do also have the doors to the cargo compartments printed on here at the back of the aircraft, and also here at the front of the aircraft. So there we have it, the Boeing 747-400 in the last Virgin Atlantic standard livery that was applied to this aircraft type from Sky 500 in scale 1 to 500. And what can we say about this aircraft model? Overall, it is a rather basic model. It doesn't really offer that many printed details, but the print itself is very nice. But I have said it many times before, with aircraft that carry a rather colorful livery, the fact that there are some missing printed details just doesn't seem as noticeable as with an aircraft that has a predominantly white livery. Still, I would have liked a few more printed details here and there. The physical detailing is, in my opinion, just fine and very much in line with what you can expect from an aircraft model from 2013. Interestingly enough, if you are on the lookout for a Virgin Atlantic 747 and with this very specific registration code, well, then you are in luck, because there's this 2013 version from Sky 500, and Harper has actually also made in 2003 a 747-400 with this exact registration code, but of course with a different Virgin Atlantic livery. So you actually have a choice, although I would definitely go for this one. And with that conclusion, it is time to end today's episode. If you have enjoyed this video, then don't forget to leave a like, that would be very much appreciated. And of course, if you are new around here, why not hit subscribe? That would be absolutely certainly awesome. With that, I'd like to say thank you very much for watching. Hope to see you soon again. I'm checking out, and bye.